Well, good morning, everyone, and welcome to this Christmas service. And we look forward to the Jam Club, who are taking most of the service this morning. And can I indicate to you that there may be some changes to the Christmas services, but we hope to carry on with everything as usual. And in the billet, you notice that the managers will notice that there is a short meeting after this morning's service. We are, of course, sorry to learn that Alan Vint, our minister, our dear minister, is in hospital, and we send him our very best wishes for a speedy recovery, of course. And this morning, I got a messenger, but a real live messenger, who gave me this information to read to you. To our Anderson Church family, on Alan's behalf, sincere thanks for the many messages of love and goodwill, as well as prayers for his recovery. The timing of Alan's illness is terrible, exclamation mark. And he is aware that the big church wheel is turning because of the highly efficient and very loving folks in our church community. And he sends his thanks, pardon me, for their willingness to ensure our Christmas season is appropriately managed. Alan is also mindful of the trials many of our community are facing this Christmas, and we both hold all those people and persons in our prayers. If technology works, he will be turning on to our service in the Royal Infirmary, Ward 64. So look out, those other patients in Ward 64, for the lovely singing that emanates from our congregation through the internet. You can be sure that there will be feedback on that from Alan. His good wishes are here today with Hazel, Dorothy, and the team, and all the children send blessings and love. And I just noticed on my smartphone, before I come up here, that let me get it on here. It says here, watch Sunday morning, a notification says, watch Sunday morning, the 18th of December, because the service is live from Anderson Church. So hello, Alan, how are you doing, son? I nearly forgot to mention that we have a double header tonight in Christmas carol services. Firstly, at 5 o'clock in the Banton Baptist Church, they invite you to join them to celebrate Christmas with the Reverend Ian Wardle and party. A night of food and fun for all the family, and all are warmly welcome. Bring a friend. And the next second house is our neighbours in Burns and Old. Burns and Old, our parish church, are having carols by candlelight tonight at 7 o'clock. So that'll give you time to get back from Banton Church to join with the Burns and Old, if you can make it. And I think these are all intimations. I hope I haven't missed anything. And we look forward to the Jam Club doing their stint for Christmas. Thank you.
Our service this morning with the singing of the first hymn, and then the children will come in during this, and it's Once in Royal David City. We're now going to have our offering video, and while we're having the offering video, we'll light the Advent candle. So if you're ready for the video, thank you.
return again as Lord of all. And because of this, we can live each day in the knowledge that ultimately you hold all things, including ourselves, in your love and care. Lord Jesus, we ask that you will forgive us if in all the busyness of shopping for presents and food and all the preparations for Christmas Day, we forget about you. The babe who was born in a stable, but 33 years later died on the cross to be our Saviour. Forgive us, Lord, when we have not made time for you in our day-to-day lives, and we've forgotten your message of reconciling love, or have ignored the stillness of your presence. So we ask our Father this morning, to the carols, the children's activities, the reading of your word, that your name will be honoured and glorified, that our hard hearts will be melted to receive you. Our Father, for some of us, the nativity story is very familiar. So we ask that you will open our eyes to see fresh challenges and give us greater understanding of the truths in your word. We ask that you will prepare each of our hearts for the coming Saviour and give us courage and real willingness to share the true meaning of Christmas with family, friends, and work colleagues if the opportunity arrives. Continue with us now and be near to everyone who takes part, especially the children. We would also pray for Alan, who would have loved to have been here. We ask for your healing upon him. Help him to rest in you. Again, our Father, we just thank you for the many gifts that you have given us, and we ask that you will bless this offering as return our love to you, and we ask that you will just use it to extend your kingdom here in this church and throughout the world. We ask it in your name. Amen. Before the children do their nativity, we're all going to join and sing, "Come and Join the Celebration."
Good morning and welcome to our Nativity. The story that you'll hear this morning is told in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, and this is our representation of it. We do hope you enjoy what we're going to show you today. Thank you.
Christmas approaches across all nations. Young children are leading the church congregations. The story of The people are waiting to see him perform the story of Jesus and when he was born.
But this time is different. We're sorry to say you won't have it easy in our church today, for we need your help this year as we tell the story, but now you should know well.
The title you find should give us away the do-it-yourself nativity play. Yes, that's what it's called. I'm sure you know why. We're hoping that none of the grown-ups are shy.
We find nativities are hard to do with many children to act, but with you, we'll have enough people to act out the play, and here are God's measures for us today.
So, just as God's taught, we plan to endeavour to work as one body and do it together. At some point, we'll ask some of you to take part, so now that I've warned you, we're ready to start.
So Mary and Joseph will start on their mission. These two will be children to keep a tradition. We mustn't forget that our Lord chose Maiden as travelling slowly as she's heavy laden. They'll start their long walk around the church as we sing our very first Christmas Welcome the King.
Third hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Oh, You may now have noticed that our Mary's plight was simpler than on that first Christmas night. We've skipped past the part where Joseph has knocked on all of the doors and they've stayed firmly locked. Of course, for a while, they had nowhere to stay, but here they are now in a shed full of hay. A place which is meant for the cows to be kept, yet that was the first place that God's own son slept. Now Jesus is in Mary's arms to keep warm. We've picked up the story from after he's born. Now out in the field on that wonderful night, the shepherds were watching their sheep by moonlight. So now we need two shepherds, just two from the crowd. We don't mind who offers, we're really not proud. Could two adults go to the front over there? Anyone? No.
I'm not getting
home. We're scraping the barrel. Are you all we've got? I suppose shepherds were known to be an odd lot. Just put on a tunic and pick up a stick. We've not got all day now, come on, quick. Just stand on the spot, please, while I narrate. A bit faster, please, you're making us late. Now, as I was saying, the evening was still and the shepherds were watching their sheep on the hill. But as the night fell, there came a bright light and the shepherds experienced a terrible fright.
Now, this is why children do most Christmas plays. You're supposed to be doing what the story says. Is that how you look when you've had a bad fright? Children, you should them because you'll do it right.
Well, on with the story. You'll just have to do. Working with grown-ups, what can you do? Anyway, it seemed the light in the sky came from an angel hovering up high. She shared with the shepherds great news of our Lord. I'm sorry to say that you grown-ups look bored. Just try to pretend that you know what to do. Don't worry, I'm sure no one's looking at you.
So as I was saying, the angel then told the wonderful news to the shepherds.
Behold, I bring you good news of wonderful joy. The birth in a stable of a baby boy. In Bethlehem, you will find Jesus, God's Son, said to be the Saviour of everyone.
Then all of a sudden, more angels appeared. I'm sorry, but here's where it really gets weird. For ladies, we'll need some of you about now to make us believe that you're angels somehow. The rest of us need real imagination to be taken by this transformation. We'll need volunteers as angels just there. The children will give you some wings to wear. You'll need plenty of time to get ready, no doubt. So when we start singing, could you please come out?
Hey, fellow volunteers are getting ready. We're going to sing Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Thank you. I don't know about you, but I really don't find those angels convincing. Oh well, never mind. The shepherds that moment decided to go to Bethlehem where they'd been told. And so while they find the babe who was born to be king, we'll give them some time as we sing the next hymn.
So our next song is going to be Silent Night.
We need two more adults. Could two more join in? We'll need two of you to pretend to be kings. Come out then. We're waiting. It's a Christmas play. It has to be finished by Christmas Day. Just put on your costumes, there's no need to worry. Don't mind us, we wouldn't want you to hurry. We don't mind waiting. You just take your time. There's really no rush. Everything's fine. Now finally you've got the cloak and the crown, but would you mind losing that horrible frown? Now each of you needs your own gift for the baby. They're all in that chair. Could you choose one each maybe? Then go to the stable and regally offer your gifts to the child and bow as you proffer. Jesus. honestly, really, you can't get the staff. You call that regal? You're having a laugh. Oh well, just sit down because it's time to move on. And as you get settled, we'll sing the next song.
The story is finishing there. Let's face it, they're singing today everywhere as all celebrate this Christmas morn when Jesus our Saviour, the Christ, was born. And the tableau at the front hopefully will be able to sing, "We wish you a Merry Christmas." Okay.
There's houses and shops covered in decorations, but where is the babe as we enjoy the sights? Does he go away when we take down the lights? We must all remember to make sure and share the message of Jesus with people who care. All those who listen must know he still lives. How can they receive if none of us gives? We hope that today we have opened your eyes and that through our service you will realise you can't leave it to us to tell of God's worth by nativity plays of Jesus' birth. It's just once a year and we're a small team, but God has so much of the world to redeem. And our next hymn is "Away in a Manger."
Oh,
let us remember, united we stand as we share God's message of love through the land. So now may we leave equipped to proclaim the wonderful good news in Jesus' name.
Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always and to the very end of the age. This reading is taken from Matthew chapter 28, verse 19 to 20.
Go into all of the world and preach the gospel to all of creation.
Can I have a big hand again for all our super volunteers? You're all brilliant. Thanks very much, guys. And if you want to return to your seats, that would be lovely. You can keep the props if you want. Please don't set fire to your wind, Olivia. I've been watching them. They're awful close to that candle. Okay, so everybody wants to thank them. I'd like to ask you all if you can join me in prayer just now, please. Okay, let's pray. Father God, we come humbly before you now on this Advent Sunday. We remember Christians all over the world who are joining with us in the excitement and anticipation of Christmas. For those who are being persecuted for their beliefs or who must worship in secret, we ask for your blessing and protection. Today, in this place, we thank you for the warmth, the lights, and the fellowship of our church family. But for those who are cold, hungry, homeless, or alone, we ask that they might find comfort and nourishment. Please encourage the supporters of our food banks and those who provide emergency accommodation to those who need it most. We bring before you those who are affected by conflict in the Middle East, especially the innocent victims of this war. Please give support to the British medical teams heading to Syria this week. We also remember families who have been separated by arguments or disagreements. It is our prayer that there may indeed be peace this Christmas. Our sympathies are with those who are mourning the loss of a loved one at this time of year, as it can be especially hard. Please let your spirit lead them through this difficult stage. May we ask for guidance for anyone facing important life changes in the year ahead in terms of career or family circumstances. Let them trust the Holy Spirit to take them on the path that is best and right for them. For victims of crime, we pray for justice and forgiveness. For the perpetrator, we ask for repentance and reformation. We also ask for resolution among prisoners who have been rioting this week. And at this time, we bring before you our friends and families who are ill or in hospital. Each one of them is known to you, Lord. We ask that your grace will bring them to full health in mind and in body. We pray for the professionals assigned to provide treatment or care. Grant them wisdom, strength, and confidence. Our thoughts are especially with Alan and wee Lauren and their families, and we pray that they will soon be back with us. Thank you, Lord, that you hear our prayers, not just at Christmas, but always. Thank you that you sent Jesus to be our salvation. And it is in his name that we pray as we say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Loving Father, we give you thanks today that once again we've been able to make that journey back to Bethlehem to share and to rejoice together with all those who have come to see Christ and believed in him through the ages. For those who on that first night went down to Bethlehem to see the wonder that had come to pass. And for all those who in the years to come will make this same journey to find the one who is Saviour and Lord of the world. And now, Father, we pray that your blessing will be upon us throughout the whole of this Advent and Eastertide. The united blessing of God, who is the Father and whose Son and who is the Holy Spirit, now and always. Amen. I believe there's a short video to follow.
Thank you. just want to say a very quick thank you just before everyone goes again to all the volunteers and especially to the children, because it's not just Alan that's been not well. A few of the cast weren't able to come either, so we had to have last minute stand-ins, and I think everybody did really, really well. So thank you again. Very Merry Christmas to everyone. A big clap for all our helpers. Thanks.
And I think we need to say a big thank you to Hazel and the staff of the Sunday School as well. At the very last minute yesterday, they were thrown in to coordinate. They had it all arranged, but at the last minute, they were sort of expected just to pull the whole thing together. So well done, Sunday Jam Club.